Double tap it so you know how I feel. I don't even know what your name is. To show you that I'm there, I'm liking shit from weeks ago. Don't try to front.
Okay. Hello. Welcome to my ninth day of wellness. Today, we're going to be cooking stuffed bell peppers. We have bell peppers here. We're going to stuff them with jambalaya and shrimp and sausage. So, teach you how to make that. So, the first thing you're going to do is technically called prepping. So, cut all of your stuff. In this case, your sausage. So, we just got regular sausage, like beef smoked sausage, and all you have to do is cut it up into like little circles, spears, little slices, whatever. Now, all you have to do is peel your shrimp. This is the rice that we use. Pour your rice in. Oh, I hope y'all are smart enough to know. Please put water in your pot for your rice. Do not put it in there dry with just the stovetop and the oil. Don't do that. Add like a tablespoon of oil. Yeah, that's pretty good. And then your meat. Add your meat. Once you add your meat, make sure you watch it and let it come to a boil. And then, yeah, just keep an eye on your rice. Okay, so while your rice is boiling, make sure you keep an eye on it because when it's close to being done, you need to put the shrimp in there so it can cook and da 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 da. So now, this is where the pepper comes in. This is a bell pepper. Delicious, yes. So you have to clean this and make it available for rice to be stuffed in it. So what you're gonna do is wash it. And we're back. So this part right here, cut this off. You can save it because it's kind of like a cute decor. You can save this part because it's kind of a cute decor to like put back on top of the rice and stuff like that. So there's gonna be this part. You just cut around it, cut around the stem, part thingy, and the seeds and all that stuff. And then it should easily just like come out. You probably kind of have to pull, but easily it should just come out. Simple. And then just get the rest of it. Make sure like you have enough space to put rice and stuff and stuff it. Hint on stuff. Bell peppers. Available pepper for your rice. And then technically you do that to like all the other peppers you have. Technically what you do. So that's done. You put them on a pan. Like you put your peppers on a pan so that when you stuff them, you put them in the oven so they can cook. Or else you're just eating raw peppers, which is no problem. So I kind of forgot that we had two rice things or two packets of rice. So I have to move to a bigger pot, but it's all good. It's the same thing. I added my shrimp. So yeah. Besides my feet on the sixth day of Christmas, my baby gave to me crop jacket with dirty denim jeans. My baby gave to me. Yeah, I like that. Spicy. So now that your rice is done, this is where you stuff your bell peppers. Okay, so first thing you do, get a pepper, clean, then you stuff. Now you get a spoonful of your rice, and you literally just do that. Be careful though, because it's still hot. It should be still hot. And just, oh God, stuff as much as you can into one pepper. This is mine. I'm already calling it. Orange is the best flavor once it's cooked. Once you stuff one, what it should look like, then it just sits. and then you do the rest.
A candle lit dinner just for me and my honey. On the third day of Christmas, my baby gave to me a gift certificate to get my favorite CDs. On the second day of Christmas, my baby gave to me the keys to a CLK Mercedes. On the first day of Christmas, my baby gave to me quality T.I.M.E.
So technically, after you take them out the oven, you're done. Like, it's over, it's done, you can eat. Like a quick little like 10 minute, 15 minute meal for the family or just even yourself. But that's pretty much all I have. Thanks for watching and I will see you tomorrow. We've been on a tragedy for once. Why can't you agree?